Now we shall learn how to send a view model to a view. This is something that you're going to do a lot, because view model allows you to send a lot of data. Let us see how the concept works. From what we have done in the previous, we are getting a list in a variable, and then finally we are setting it into a view. The limitation is that this concept, you should understand it very carefully, because I have seen people take some time to understand this one. This is one limitation. The limitation is that you can only send one object into view. Now if this is a list of, let us say, TBL airlines, and I want to send current date equal to now, I also want to send current date to the view. Now I can't pass this as a separate object, I can't pass this as a separate object, because only one argument is possible in a view where data can be passed. You can't write like this, view LST comma current date. This is simply not allowed. There has to be a workaround. The workaround is through view model concept, which allows you to virtually pass unlimited amount of data to the view. Unlimited amount of data to the view. The trick is this. Create a class, let me call it my view model. Any name, it is not compulsory that it should be ending in view model or it should be my view model. You can give any name to this class. I'm writing class my view model. And here I'll set a property public list angle bracket whatever, and here I'll write flights followed by the get set story. Then I can add another property public date current date or whatever, add even more properties, add even more class objects, collections. You can add as many properties down here. Therefore, you can send as much data as you can. View model is the way. And then you create an object of my view model inside your action, set all these properties and pass that object to the view. So in that way, you'll be able to pass all this data into one object, flatten into one object, and send that object to the view. And then access that object with the capital model. Since all these properties are public, we can write model.flights. It will give me access to all the flights. So this is the basic concept that we'll work here, and let us see the implementation. This is the project we were doing the last time. We queried TBL Airlines, passed them to the view, and inside the view we showed them in a for each loop. This is what we did in the last lecture. Now there is a requirement that current date should also be passed. So what we'll do is we'll go to the Solution Explorer, right click, add a folder called View Models. I recommend you should use a folder called View Models. It will organize your code better. Right click, add . So this is what we can do, public date time, current date, so if I want to not only pass flights but also a discrete item like current date, then I'll have to create a class of view models in which I'll set two properties. And now I'll come to my home controller. I can do one thing. I'll have to first of all at the top put using. Okay. Now I can do here my view model. Is equal to new my view model, and here control space flights is equal to query comma current date is equal to date time dot today or now, whatever you want. This is then we can pass here MVM. Now this is a concept that is being illustrated, but you could be a little smarter, like instead of doing what I've done, you could have simply done it this also, flattened the story into one line. Here your own programming art will be put into practice. It's your art how you program it, but the concept is what I'm illustrating right now. Return view MVM, and coming to my index. Remember at the top I'll have to write the data type of what is coming in. So what I'll write here is, since I am getting not an enumeration, the type is my view model. So I'll write the complete path. This is the type of the class that is coming into it. Now my for each loop will complain because model is no longer a collection, because it is a view model object now. To reach that collection, I'll write this. It is settled. And similarly, I'll do one thing, I'll just put here date. Date is equal to at the rate model dot current date. And if I want to format it, it is possible because we can use our C# for all these stories. Now you can run and see that we have succeeded in sending heterogeneous data. One is for this date time and the other is for the flights table. You can send as much data and display it wherever you want on the page. Stock quotes this side. You have to just write the for each loop down here, accessing your model dot whatever collection you are getting from behind. So little imagination now and you can see that view model does help in things. We could have sent one more, another table also, do anything. Context is with you. You could have added another property, ctx dot another table dot to list, maybe order by query and all that, and then access it on your index.cshtml page as you like. I have an exercise for you. Create a ViewModel class called CCustomData that sends current date, your company name and a collection of 5 int. So this you can create yourself, list of int and all. Display the data on the view. You have to do all the steps. Create a ViewModel folder, add a class to that, add proper namespaces, create an object of CCustomData, set its properties, pass them to the view, set @smallModel on the view, and then put all the queries to display the data. So we'll close it right now. Thanks.